بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Curriculum design for physical therapy educational program will be introduced by Fatin Abdulazim.
أميمة قطابة.
Lecture objectives of this course: after completing this lecture, the student will be able to state the four questions posed by Ralph Taylor to guide design and describe the three phases of process of how faculty engage in the curriculum development as suggested by Dekker Walker.
Also defend the need for a clearly stated program philosophy to guide curriculum planning. Demonstrate how program and goals can be articulated with university philosophy, needs, and professional functions. The last one, define implicit, explicit and null curriculum and identify component of each type.
These are our objectives for the today. Primary purpose for this course is to stimulate the growth of physical therapists in teaching and learning by presenting theoretical concept and related this theoretical concept to related practical application that will be improved skills. So here we will introduce theoretical concept and matching with the practical application that will facilitate or enhance improvement of skill in educational process. This may be used in academic as well as clinical setting. What is the teaching and what is the learning?
For the student to learn, they must comprehend and transform ideas, information, and beliefs through inquiry and reflection during learning experiences. In which way? In which they, the students, are active participants and collaborators. Such learning results in change of the student's store of information, their beliefs, perception, feelings, and their interactions between them.
So throughout our course may be differentiate between learning and teaching. Learning means a change in individual behavior caused by experiences or self-activity. While teaching, you can't give what you don't have. It is a process that enables a learner to learn in his own way.
The process of teaching and learning is two inseparable sides of the same coin. Considering one person as a teacher and another as a learner is an artificial distinction. As we say, kinesthetic perception and functional movement should be considered as two separate and distinct entities. For either process to work well, both process must be work in current. That means the process of teaching and learning must be concurrent together at any time.
And in the same way, we can't separate both of them from each other. As the previous example, kinesthetic perception and the functional movement, not easy to separate each one from the other. So at any given moment, by this meaning, anyone may be the learner or the teacher, parent and the families, the student participating in the formal academic programs, health care, colleagues, community, neighbors, and also oneself peer. So this is interchangeable. From teacher will be the learner and the vice versa. Effective teaching involved. To be effective in my way of teaching, must be have a lot of knowledge, comprehending knowledge, deeply comprehending information to be taught to the topics, to the subject, to be taught the student must be have a lot of information to be able to simplify and introduce to my student. Another point, being able to transform and present this information in a way that students get it. Once more, engaging the student in active, collaborative learning experience, not to go to through the teaching process by yourself, but must attract, must get the student one steps of your learning process must participate by asking, by demonstrate, by present his activity in varieties of ways that represent his get this information. And the last one, teaching the student how to learn by constant inquiry and reflection, which leads the student to acquire her new knowledge and comprehension to be able to transform this information and skill to new environment.
هل learning ممكن يكون fragmented؟ هل intended learning outcomes ممكن تأثر على academic educators، على الطلبة، على الكلينيشنز، علينا، على جميع الأخصائيين وما بيشتغلوا؟
Sure. Intended learning outcome must be achieved. That what to say the course can be good and understandable. Otherwise, if the student cannot achieve intended learning outcome, that means he cannot gain any knowledge or information. So the student must be achieved all to be passed through the exam, must gain all and achieve all intended learning outcome.
Okay. يعني نقدر نقول fragmented learning and embarrassingly limited outcomes in academic and clinical settings ده often occur. ما نقدرش نقول لا، وهو ده للأسف. طب هل في حل للموضوع ده؟
And also it's considered as disaster.
أكيد أكيد. طب السوليوشن هنا إيه؟ I like to use our ingenuity and strengths as healthcare providers and teachers. طب الأسئلة اللي بتطرح نفسها هنا لازم نجاوب عليها. When we find ourselves competing with time and cost to deliver the most effective healthcare possible, do we find ourselves teaching more? Are we involving the patient as well as family and caretaker much earlier in learning to assume healthcare tasks? Are we thinking about
this may be considered from different point of view. That what to say, for example, in pediatrics, if our patient can be dealing with him as early intervention, if it's early intervention will be consume a lot of effort and a lot of money, whatever for the federal, for the government, and also for Ministry of Health.
Okay. The next question, are we thinking about what we as physiotherapists can do to facilitate health practice and in the community? And how we figured out what is essential for novice practitioners, اللي هم practitioners المبتدئين, to know how can prepare them to acquire knowledge throughout their professional lives? كل الأسئلة دي, we will answer all these questions throughout this course.
So now we are going to have to design a curriculum. Curriculum design. Everything depends upon quality of the experience is had. Quality of any experience has two aspects. There is an immediate aspect that is agreeableness or another aspect disagreeableness. And there is influence upon later experiences. The first means the quality is obvious and easy to judge. The effect of an experience is not born in its face. It set a problem to the educator, which may be reflect in the philosophy or rationale for the institute or university.
The central problem. The central problem of an education based upon experience is to select and find the kind of experiences that live fruitfully and creatively in subsequent experiences.
So now you are going to discuss the planning and organization of the curriculum. This is what you are going to introduce for us.
Yes, curriculum design refers to what? To the content and organization of the curricular elements of philosophy, goals, course work, clinical experiences, and evaluation processes. The rational assumptions that drive the curriculum designed for the education of the physical therapist is what? To prepare our preparation for practice in healthcare arena. This involves development of knowledge, of course, knowledge, skills, attitude, value that under جيرند كومبوننت اوف فيزيكال ثيرابي براكتس. كل الحاجات ديت بنحتاجها في البراكتس. A curriculum design reflect inputs directly and indirectly from thousands of people.
So we are not dealing with any issue as direct, but may be reflected also in indirect way. This whatever feedback from direct way or indirect way come from a thousand of people. As we mentioned before, may be from experience of whoever in the field. That to say, people with the health care needs, regulatory bodies such as regional and professional accreditation group, and the state board license agency, this may reflect his own in developing curriculum. As in a lot of faculty, the to be accredited, who is high rate of success in license exam. Member of the ACTA who act on professional standards plus physical therapy clinician, all of this affect and affect by curriculum design. Faculty and administrator in the college or university, this is the major or the first one to be affect and affect as it gaining new knowledge. Which is a program is located and each generation of the student have an impact on the curriculum design. So the curriculum design must be stated fastly, relevant to the current task and the standard of the physical therapy practice and the dynamicity responsiveness to rapidly changing practice environment and the human health care needs. Developing curriculum. Eli Isina noted that word curriculum originally come from Latin word mean curar, which means the course of to be run. He states this notion imply track a set of obstacles or tasks that an individual is to overcome, something that has beginning and an end, something that one aim and completing.
So curriculum development should be an ongoing process to ensure excellence in clinical practice and to provide learning experiences. For your information, if you don't know where you are going and how, you will never reach the final station.
Now we are going to start the first question from Taylor, fundamental question. The four fundamental questions identified by Ralph Taylor 1949, so it's acquainted to history, and still we are take it as a reference to developing a curriculum. In deciding how to develop a resources, these four questions are discovered by each generation of faculty seeking to developing physical therapy curriculum. So if you are going to seek for effective curriculum to be developed, must not to miss or forget Taylor for fundamental questions. The first one, what educational purpose or goals should be school seek to attain? Next, what educational experience can be provided that are likely attain this purpose? Third, how can these educational experiences be effectively organized? Last one, how can it be determined whether this purpose or goals attained?
Question and answer to these questions must be interrelated, بمعنى each one building on the preceding question and answer. If not follow this sequence when designing a curriculum, that means knowledge about everything, it like sailing a ship without no clear destination and it will be a disaster. Question number 2 and 3 is easy to answer, while starting to answer number 4 without answering number 2 and 3, this will be the obvious disaster.
So here we are going to clarify what this diagram means. This diagram relationship between curriculum design, Taylor fundamental question and Walker neutralistic model. The first column explain how the curriculum to be developed. To develop any curriculum, if we are looking in the bottom of this diagram, program and the institutional philosophy, this is the first issue must be imposed to develop the curriculum. Then develop program goals, and then program objectives, and then course work content. This may be take from learning experience and evaluation. As you're looking for the arrow, it work in different in both direction. That means it take and give to each other. So the first one, evaluation of the program to the graduate, will be integrated matching with the first question of the tailor. How can be determined whether this purpose or being attained? How to achieve this purpose? By evaluation of the program from the graduate. The second and the third, the second question will dealing direct with learning experience, go to evaluation, and then back force to the learning experience. Both of them will be back to coursework content. This means must be achieved the content by learning the student. Student gains the experience, then evaluate this experience, and this may be achieved by different element of content for the course. Then the step above or step next to this, program objectives achieved by course content. Here we are going to dealing with one course. Through DBT program we have a lot of courses. All of these courses achieve program objectives. Here in this course we are going to achieve some objective for this course. Collection of the course, all of them will achieve all program objectives, which reflect in the program goals, which finally give us the program institutional philosophy. So here the second question represented by learning evaluation. What is the third one? Third question of Taylor. Third question of Taylor, which clear what educational experience can be provided that are likely to attain this purpose can be achieved through course content and the program objectives. The last question of Taylor, what educational purpose should the school seek to attain? ايه هي اللي عايزة تحققه المدرسة دي او السكول او اليونيفرسيتي دي؟ This achieved by two element take and give to each other through program goals and the program and the institutional philosophy. Now we are discuss the interaction between curriculum development and the four Taylor question, how we can integrate this with the Walker neutralistic model. Walker divided into two phases only, design decision and deliberation. This is a platform of beliefs. The first one dealing with the second question of Taylor, design decision depend in how can this educational experience be effective organized. The last step of the Walker neutralistic model is deliberation, which is dealing or integrated with two last question of the Taylor, what educational experiences can be provided that are likely to attain this purpose, plus what educational purpose should be school seek to attain.
بمعنى كده لو احنا لخصنا الكلام اللي انت قلتيه ده كله على الفيجر اللي هو relationship between curriculum design, Taylor fundamentals question and Walker neutralistic models, نقدر نقول in designing curriculum all these elements must be logically ordered. This logic may be obtained by thinking how each level is directly responsive to the level above and below. This is clear in the figure. In curricular design column, which is the left column, containing the educational program course, work, learning expectation or learning experience, evaluation process, all this must be meeting the program objective design to fulfill the program goal. All this can be reflected in the program philosophy and institution. And finally, the evaluation of this program graduate therefore demonstrates the success or lack of success of the program's ability to build a curriculum that meets its needs, of course.
So you are going to clarify for us this interaction between the different rationale for the different group as Walker model and the Taylor question as a program. So if any one of them missed, maybe lead to lack or unsuccess for the curriculum.
Exactly. This is APTA monograph, which demonstrates how philosophy and the goals of any physical therapy curriculum are embedded in a global, that means macro environment, that include society, healthcare environment, the higher education system, and knowledge related to physical therapy. The normative model of physical service professional education version 2000s admit lina حاجتين, admit lina macro environment and micro environment, which we'll talk about later.
You mean you start to discuss Taylor question number one, program philosophy and the goals?
Yes, yes. It is obvious that when any component of this macro environment changes, it is necessary to consider changing in the physical therapy curriculum. Example, federal government movement in support of health promotion prevention activities. Can you give me another example?
Before we transfer to another example, we can clarify this diagram. Okay. Here, if we're looking for this diagram, in the center is the physical therapy professional education. And the three circles bisect by each other. This three circle is the healthcare environment, body of knowledge, and the higher education. All of this put in the center education, physical therapy professional education. This reflects global environment, so the physical therapist professional education may be affect and affect the society. It is considered as a part of it. This which is represented in macro or global environment as presented by Taylor question one, number one, program philosophy and the goals. So the example here, we are going maybe represent clear example. All of the physical therapy dealing with the patient, but nowadays we are dealing to look for the patient, not the patient, dealing with the disease which are not appear as need for physical therapy. As again, if we are going to give an example for communicable disease, not well distributed by physical therapy to attack this one. But nowadays we are thinking and looking to attack this disease. So if we are going to discuss this issue, so first of all we are going to make a survey in the environment to pick up or gather information about this communicable disease, which in long run maybe affect the physical therapy field or the client there will be as a client for physical therapy. This I think may be clear example for you.
Okay, returning back to the macro environment which introduced by APTA. Okay, احنا بنعتبر ان ال normative model of physical service professional education version 2000 and the guideline to physical therapist practice have been a gift to physical therapy educator. It helped educators to define the body knowledge related to the physical therapist. One of the main functions of the normative model is what? Number one, provide a mechanism for existing, developing, future professional education program to evaluate the refined curriculum and integrate aspects of the profession's vision for professional education into their vision.
This point is come inconsistently with the example just I introduced.
Yes.
So I'm looking for the future. If we are looking for a communicable disease, so the patient now, not a patient, we are looking for if what is the complication will be had to be a patient in physical therapy. So this common matching or integrating and relevant for this area.
That's why the normative model is based on 19 practice expectation that defines the expected entry level performance of the physical therapist. Also, it can be used by educators, this, I mean the monograph, to review how their coursework is fundamental and clinical science related to examples of content, terminal behavior, objectives, and related instructional objectives suggested by content experts. Together, all of this, the normative model and the guidance to physical therapy practice, are extremely useful resources for any physical therapist, clinical or academic educator, who carries the responsibilities to transmitting the core knowledge of physical therapy to the next generation. In addition to ATTA, there is a Journal of Physical Therapy Education. This is a steady stream of idea and the special issues directed towards the physical service, and it can be found anywhere.
Sure. We are back again for the view of system environment within which physical therapy education exists. So, physical therapy professional education, as we mentioned before, it as a part represent as a part of society, and it reflects according to society's need. So here, if we are going to look for this diagram, it may be clear, clarify a little bit the other one. Here, higher education and health environment care, regularity agency, knowledge supporting the disciplinarian of physical therapy, institutional environment, and back again to higher education, find it is a circle. Each one of them can be effect and the effect of another one. This is what is already happening in the field of physical therapy and the physical therapy profession. To educate the physical therapy and the graduate, we can find it is be affected by all of this domain and the issue.
This is an example for proposed general educational objectives.
Here we are going to teach the students the language of physical therapy. The physical therapy has the language, yes, the different modalities, the different technique may be considered as a modality for physical therapy. What updating in this field consider as a language for physical therapy? And underburdening disciplinarian for anatomy, pathology, physiology, kinesiology, whatever all the branch tackled by physical therapy must be have a language for this expression, for this specialty.
Introduce students to the ways of science. Teach them to understand and respect the nature of scientific evidence.
Also, teach the student how to reason and manage and the gap in the knowledge, how to fulfill the gap in the knowledge. If the student is going to read about something or have experience in something, must be go back to the library to get the missed data from him.
Teach students how to communicate with people from different cultures, values, system, and background.
Also, must expand the student capacity for constructive empathy. Teach students to help each other by using their own compassion, and also this may be achieved one asks the student to work in the team or as a group. This helped them a lot, whatever among his peers or when dealing with the patient.
Also can introduce the student to the social concerns that exist beyond the issues of the patients they treat. Foster feeling of responsibility for those who are poor or isolated persons. Inculcate a personal love of learning, help students develop habits required for continuing education or continuing learning.
This means by the end of the student to get graduated, this not meaning at all the student stop the way of learning and teaching. Must be continuous education as science not stop, but the science by in this era we are living in a revolution in science in everything. So must teach the students also how to can catch up with the new information to be acquainted with the patient, not so far from the patient problem. David Rogers proposed a study of balls for medical educators. This acquainted to history also, as a lot of researcher in the history started this process. And the student poured enough to be responsiveness to the global environment, knowledge, critical thinking, humanity skills, professional responsibility and obligation. All of these are essential for the student to be achieved, to get sight or get apart from curriculum development. Health professional must better organize professional education around what? This what I mean. All of us have documentation for the teaching. The course program include blah blah blah. The course objective include blah blah blah. This is by documentation. So what is essential to be achieved? The excellent way to teach must be what is documented achieved. But sometimes there is some gap. This is what we call actually happen and what is should be happen. So what is in documentation, this what should be happen. But in the reality, what is the actual happen? So student must be taught, example Lena, thinking inside skill as reflection in action and reflection on action. Intellectual humanity as well as social responsibility. To prepare the student for this, a complex, unique, uncertain and changeable health care, they will be facing.
Once again, this is a conceptual framework for the curriculum, which concerning the microenvironment within which the physical therapy educational exists. These figures demonstrate how a particular physical therapy curriculum is impeded in its microenvironment, or let's say immediate educational institution and the clinical practical settings. It is process for uniqueness among the philosophy, goals of the physical therapy educational programs.
So you mean physical therapy education setting must contain prerequisite and practice expectation. Prerequisite as admission of the criteria for the student, practice expectation, what is expected from other graduate to achieve. To achieve this one, physical therapy educational setting contain developed by curriculum. This developed curriculum, as mentioned before, consists of four elements: foundation science, as clear in this diagram, clinical science and the transcurricular content, plus clinical education. As we mentioned before, the feedback is essential to develop any curriculum. For physical therapy education setting also, the feedback is essential. So when the student is admitted to the program of physical therapy, prerequisites for the student must be clear enough what it had before to enter the field or the school for physical therapy. The curriculum achieved through four elements we discussed: foundation science, clinical science, transcurricular content and clinical education. This achieved educational outcome which the student or graduate meet a practitioner for expectation.
Okay.
However, it believes the program will influence the student growth. This means when the student prerequisite enter as a newly student for DBT program or for BST program, it believes the program will influence the student growth. That means will add the skills and information for the student. This assumption were developed by faculty and provide the framework for development and direction of individual coursework. This means all of the courses together will enhance and promote the student growth whatever in professional through the academic and skills. Time considering macro level and the micro level philosophy and the goal, time will be spent with the student to achieve these goals.
This table demonstrated how the philosophy and goals of the micro environment influence the program's philosophy, goals, and outcomes and curriculum. Both micro level and macro level philosophy and goals has to be considered when developing a program curriculum. It's also show a mission statement that identifies the mission of the university as well as the program's mission of DBT.
So we can clear by the table 4.1, the primary mission of the Department of Physical Therapy are to provide the opportunity for individuals from diverse culture to ensure and enter physical therapy profession. So that's to say, never to consider the previous culture as obstacles or limitation for anyone to admit to the DBT program. Next, to prepare physical therapy practitioners to meet the health care needs of society. As we also discussed before, it must needs in the society needs, not to go in the branch so far from the needs of the population or the patient in society. And then to discover and to convey knowledge related to physical therapy. What is the most important knowledge relevant to physical therapy must be discovered throughout the course. In addition, all of the previous, to provide service to academic, professional, and the public communication. Now we are going further to the next question of Taylor. Second question discuss educational experiences. Once the goal and the philosophy are understood as we explained in the first question, the next question to be answered is what educational experience are needed to achieve this purpose? Coursework in physical therapy program usually consists of
four elements. These four elements, number one, foundation sciences such as anatomy, pathology. Number two, clinical sciences such as therapeutic exercise, management of patient with specific clinical problems, for example, orthopedic or cardiopulmonary. Transcurricular content such as ethics, administration and research. And finally, clinical education such as this will be talk about later on the conceptual.
Clinical education is all the courses introduced for the student in the clinical class, as in pediatric, in orthopedic, in gynecology, whatever. All of this considered as clinical education.
We took already in previous on the conceptual framework for the curriculum, okay?
Yes.
The actual coursework designed and offered depend on what? The program's practice expectation and the types of depths of prerequisites coursework. Within each course, written identify specific attitudes, behavior, and the skills that the instructor expects each student to develop, which relate directly to the programs of philosophy and goals. For your information, if one of the program's goal is to develop critical thinking skills, each instructor should present objectives and related learning experience to stimulate development of students' abilities to reflect, critically analyze and make rational decisions.
So now, as we are teaching in DBT program or doctoral physical therapy program, we are looking for philosophy, goals and outcome, and overview of the curricular themes, Temple University. The first one, doctoral physical therapy philosophy. What is the philosophy for this degree? Students enter the program from diverse culture, as I mentioned before, not related to special or specific culture, and also educational background differ. The program educates graduates to practice ethically in diverse healthcare, setting to serve the present and the future needs of the diverse society, and to engage in lifelong professional development. Graduates are prepared with professional behavior skills and critical thinking skills, in addition to theoretical and practical knowledge, psychomotor skills. So all this previous will enable the student, DBT student, to assume the multifaceted lifelong roles of the healthcare professional. That's to say, not to stay at the level he achieved through this program, but through the program, teach him how to keep continuous education. Clinical practitioner, manager, teacher, learner, consultant, researcher, and advocate. DBT goals and outcome. The performance of successful graduate of this program includes examination, evaluation, diagnosis of prognosis, diagnosis of different cases, prognosis for varieties of cases, and intervention for all the discussed cases, for human movement dysfunction to produce defined outcome.
Promotion of wellness and prevention of illness for individuals and communities.
Evidence-based practice within the patient care management and disablement framework, which is based on scientific principles and the critical inquiry, including analysis of effective outcome, not just what is outcome, but we must look for the quantity as well as quality. So we are looking for the quality of the outcome from the perspective of both the healthcare system and the person and the family receiving the service. If they are satisfied by this service or need more modification of the different program.
Practice that is responsive to the diverse psychological, sociocultural, and spiritual beliefs and needs of the person and the family receiving services.
Ethical and effective patient care management of contemporary physical therapy service.
Ethical and effective patient care management of contemporary physical therapy services, also professional behavior in all aspects of performance.
Lifelong learning direct at continuity in broad physical therapy care. So what we all are looking for or seeking for, just to improve physical therapy care. Care for whom? Care for the client. Who is the client? The patient is the center of physical therapy intervention.
Engagement in the growth and development of the profession of physical therapy through service, including participation in the clinical and
dedicated education of future practitioner and colleagues. Collaboration, coordination, and consultation with the other healthcare profession, government agency, and the care management organization to facilitate clinically effective and the cost-effectiveness service.
Scholarly contribution to the professions is based on the disablement model. Also emphasizes practice based on theory and evidence and their interactions. Includes knowledge of the measurement properties of tests and measures used in examining patients.
All these points are going to discuss through DBT curricular theme that support the philosophy and the goals and outcome of the DBT curricula. Also, uses the patient care management model, includes attention to biological differences over the lifespan and their influence on health and disease. So must consider all of this point in order to miss or forget any of this point when dealing with or concerning the philosophy for the program. emphasis continuous ethical behavior, emphasis lifelong professional development. This is what to say continuous education. By the end of the DBT program, this is not mean that you are learn or teach for all the life, but emphasis lifelong professional development must be considered as a graduate from DBT program.
This figure shows a logical connection between an element of a program's philosophy or mission and how course in the pediatrics presents these elements in course objectives, required reading, and stimulation of student thought during examination.
Here we are looking for this diagram, program philosophy mission. This can be reflected from program goals. Program goals also reflected his view from the courses and the course objectives, and also reflected by course content learning experience. Course content itself not represent anything, but must be clear by learning experiences. And the last step, course evaluation. So to achieve program philosophy and mission, as you mentioned before, program evaluation graduate, it depends upon course evaluation at the end, not at the end, but continuous, at the end of its module or at the end of its unit. So program goals achieved by course objectives and by course content and the learning different experiences, and the course evaluation at the end lead to the graduate of the student. This can be achieved to prepare physical therapy practitioner to meet the health care needs of society. Awareness of accountability for self and the life of other in currently the diverse world. Neurological dysfunction, for example, in pediatrics, discuss the influence of culture diversity in family and the other impact in this may have on working with the family and their infant with the neuromotor impairment. So student knowledge, attitude, and behavior related to cultural diversity evaluated in clinical education must be clear. Must the student able to represent himself how this course changing behavior and reflect in attitude and performance with the patient? So it will be clear in clinical education, clinical initial employment and lifelong practice. Now we are move forward to the Taylor question number 3. This question discusses organizing. Taylor suggests 3 factors to consider in organizing experiences. The first one, continuity, then sequence and integration. These 3 elements of organization consider or described by question 3rd. First one, Taylor, consider continuity in organization.
Continuity means or referred to the vertical reiteration of curricular elements that is providing continuing opportunities for students to practice and develop. Develop what? Develop the cognitive, affection, or psychomotor skills they have learned. For example,
you mean cognitive, affective, or psychomotor skills that they have learned. This is considered as component for domain for teaching.
Example, teaching students good body mechanics in early basic skills lab must follow practicing in clinical lab courses, not practicing also, but practicing and reiteration in clinical lab courses.
So now we discuss the second point from organization, it is the sequence. Question number 3 of Taylor, organization, first one was
continuity,
and the second one, sequences, is related to continuity but move beyond the retention and the development of the single skills. Here, not related to the single skill, it move forward, move more advanced. This is means the process of having each experience, the student gains experience, this build on the period one. So now he established the first one, the first station has experience. So in the next one, build imperial experience. So it's accumulated. While moving, increasing broader, broader and deeper into material. That is mean the student take more responsibility for the patient care as he gained more information and more experience. So this is spending same time with the patient every session could lead to poor sequence. That's to say he is master the skill, so it must need less time to dealing with the case. The last point of third question, organization leading to integration. Refer to horizontal relationship of learning experiences. For example, if we discuss courses like kinesiology and anatomy, course might be placed together.
To me, might be placed.
Might be placed together so the same body segments are covered within the similar time period and the knowledge gained in one course could overlap and clarify knowledge gained in the other courses. This what mean? For example, in whatever the level the student is going to teach some kind of information or skills, if we're dealing with the kinesiology and anatomy in the same level. So if we're dealing, for example, with the upper limb for anatomy, so in the same time, we're dealing with the kinesiology for the upper limb. So this is make integration and make more clarity, not to overlap the same knowledge.
Proper continuity, sequences, and integration can extraordinarily helpful in assisting students to master a curriculum content.
So here, the question of Taylor number 3, composed of 3 element.
Yes.
Organization means 3 element.
Continuity, sequence, and integration.
So must consider when teaching at any level for the BT student.
طب السؤال دلوقتي هل في أي structural constraint ممكن نحن نقابلها وإحنا بنعمل organizing للcurriculum؟
Sure. We have many obstacles or constraints may facing our in practice our program.
The primary one or the primary consideration of the academic calendar of the university in which program is located.
So the calendar itself may be considered as obstacles for the student.
Yes.
Or for the program to be achieved.
Number 2 is the availability of the clinical sites.
This is a major problem as not offered or provided for all students to send the same clinical in the same course. So availability of the clinical sites not mean the number or quality of the case, but also not all students have the same chance to observe or apply or practice clinically in the same case, even the same diagnosis, but it differ in the severity. So it is availability of the clinical sites for the similarity of the case. This is considered as one of constraint in construction structure of the curriculum.
Clinics may have the greater number of staff on vacation.
This is true. In vacation, maybe in the summer or whatever, or wherever, the BT may take a vacation, so clinics may be greater number without staff. This also become once more constraint to develop a curriculum.
Faculty and the clinical expertise must juggle across classes in different years of program.
This means if in the in certain area few number of expertise, so it become more burden, more load to transfer from among between different clinic to overcome all the classes for the different student.
So the structural constraint to organizing a curriculum for, it's not only for, this is an example also. In summary, the organization of educational experiences should relate directly to fulfilling the program's philosophy and the expected outcomes of its graduate. So, consideration of how each student will perform after graduation must considered than how many technical skills have before first clinical setting. And this is very important.
Yes, sure. Now we lost or arrive the last steps for the question of terror. Question number four, evaluation.
Concerning evaluation, yes.
So, if the objectives, content, and the learning experience course or clinical experience related to the program philosophy. So again, tailored question, the first one, philosophy and the goals, the second one, experience education, the third one, organization, and now in the last step, evaluation. So, tailor question number four, evaluation. Evaluation of what? Now we are going to evaluate the curriculum, to evaluate the graduate student, to evaluate the outcome gained for this student, the student as well as instructor evaluation of each course, and the competent will give the faculty a good sense of whether the program are being attained or not.
ILOs.
Exactly. So evaluation, of course, the ultimate measure is how the graduate in clinical practice. So now the emphasis is how the graduate to work in clinical practice. Program evaluation should cover all general and specific goals, all short and long goals, all intended learning outcome goals. Whatever the course must be achieved, the program at the end must achieve all the goals. So program evaluation, do the graduate, for example, know how to manage, measure and the gap in knowledge, how to manage difference problem, are they able to communicate with the people from different culture and the backgrounds? Do they have love of learning?
Can they teach patients, families, colleagues, and publics? Do they demonstrate professional ethical behaviors? Regular evaluation of recent graduates by survey, interviews, groups will assist the program faculty in completing the curriculum design, connections, and answering the most important curricular questions.
Now we are back for the point which is considered as important point. Not to evaluate the student throughout the course, but also evaluate the student in clinical. So it is the most important. Now after graduate, we make a survey or interview or whatever to get feedback about the student participation, performance in their clinics. Did the educational program achieve what is stated it would achieve in the program philosophy and the goals? Did the student achieve all intended learning outcome? Did the student through the courses achieve rationale and the philosophy of the university and the faculty? This important question also must be covered.
Yes, of course. How many type of curriculum we have? We have implicit curriculum, explicit curriculum, and null curriculum. Throughout the design and implementation of physical therapy curriculum, the faculty can gain insight about the program and considering the three types of curriculum that Isner identified as being taught in all educational program, the implicit again, the explicit, and null curriculum. The explicit curriculum is publicly stated and it is available to everyone. The implicit curriculum, which is more subtle and potentially more powerful, is known especially by students and graduates of the program. While null curriculum may be known to only a few or to no one, because it includes the elements that are left out of the explicit curriculum and it is potential spot in planning. Explicit curriculum. The explicit curriculum includes those explicitly defined and publicly program accepted brochures and course syllabus. Explicit curricular elements include, for example, the prerequisite courses, the program's stated philosophy, and the course outcomes, course objectives, and required readings, the sequence and type of clinical affiliation, and the faculty accreditations. Explicit elements, these elements such as location, length, and cost of the program, as well as the type of degree awarded, is guiding for the application choice of the program. Clinical instructor receive explicit curricular information on students' preparedness of their clinical affiliation, for example, description of the coursework completed by the affiliation students. When program outcomes are assessed, alumni are often asked to state their level of certification with specific courses they completed. Once easily, might consider the explicit curriculum to be the only curriculum. Implicit curriculum. The implicit curriculum includes the value, belief, and expectation that are transmitted to student by the knowledge, language, and every action or everyday action of the academic and the clinical faculty. The faculty themselves may be less aware of these values, beliefs, and expectation than students regularly receive from faculty member implicit message about the relative importance of certain type of knowledge.
What type of patients are most interesting and challenging? And what personal and professional behavior are acceptable and unacceptable? These often unconscious behaviors, for better or for worse, are powerful socializing elements that mold the future professional behavior of the student. In fact, every aspect of explicit coursework contains an implicit message. This means not a separate, but each one contains another one involved in it. For example, do the objective of the course in the clinical procedure include an emphasis on professional behaviors as well as specific manual techniques, yes or no? I like to hear the response from you. Now, after we talk about include those elements of physical therapy practice that are missing from curriculum. So non-curriculum means something missing from the curriculum, not included in curriculum. Some elements are missing because there is no voice to campaign their inclusion. Also, non-curriculum become a blind spot, and it's especially true about the area of physical therapy practice in which fewer physical therapists are currently engaged.
بمعنى أن non-curriculum has the same impact on the professional attitudes and behaviors of the students as the explicit and implicit curriculum.
So, in this part, we discuss explicit, implicit, and non-curricular. From what to learn to how to learn. Thus, from what to learn to how to learn. This not mean you as a student, but also meaning for you, the patient for you. From you, what to learn, the patient to perform, and how to learn the patient to apply for himself. If the student are thought to have to gather and analyze the information,
to increase ideas, to constantly reflect on their decisions and clinical performance,
and to identify their learning needs, what they are need to learn, must have idea about the previous level of the student, and observe academic and clinical faculty doing this. Then
they will become lifelong learners, learning as much each year in practice as they did during their matriculation in an academic program.
A program cannot teach you everything. Sure, the program not entity or purpose to teach you everything, but teach the student how to gain the knowledge. As we said, it is
خلاص البروجرام كانت
so this mean we must teach the patient the tools of teaching not the element of teaching. Program cannot teach everything, so the student must learn the tool of teaching, the tool of learning, but it can teach to the needs of the current clinical client and the prepare student to learn for all the year of their life.
An effective educational program for physical therapists is
on in which the explicit, implicit, and the null curricula are known to a faculty and are complementary. So faculty can identify strategy that will allow them to garner periodic input about their implicit as well as explicit and the null curricula from the student, alumni, clinician, and on-site accreditation team. Being able to assess and understanding the power, influence, and outcome of one's curricular effort through input from multiple parties is an intellectually challenging, rewarding, and enjoyable endeavor. So here, our client. Our student. This student influenced by all the variables around family, community, his maturity, his or her maturity, culture around, socioeconomic class, gender male or female, history. History here it depends on the previous experience he gained and finally support. So all of these elements affect the learner to be good or bad teaching to achieve curriculum or not able to achieve. Now we are going to the if we mentioned before, when we design a curriculum, we discuss three components must be integrated together. First one the curriculum, second one tailor question, and the last one was a local curricular platform. Three this element or component integrated together must be integrated to achieve effective curricula. This chapter has given the reader an overview of the rational yet dynamic process of curricular design and has identified macro as well as micro level factor that influence curricular content. So now we are back together to remember what already present throughout this lecture.
The first one talking about is in the lecture, its objectives. State the four questions posed by Ralph Taylor and suggested by Dicker Walker. Philosophy to guide curriculum planning and how articulated with the university.
Also, we talk about define implicit, explicit, and non-curricula and identify component of each type. The last one, which you must keep attention and get it so wide impression, is set the purpose of professional accreditation and outline the process of accreditation used by American Physical Therapy Association, which is called as APTA.
We talk about effective teaching and learning. Effective teaching and learning involves what? Deeply comprehending the information to be taught, being able to transform and present that information in such a way that students get it.
Also, we discuss in our lecture engaging the student in active collaborative learning experience. And the last one about effective teaching involves teaching the student how to learn
by constant inquiry and reflection, which leads the student to acquire her new knowledge and comprehension well. The other point, we are discussing developing curricula. To start developing curricula, just we announce about who is the first one start to talk about this. Olay Isinar noted that word curriculum originally come from Latin word curae, which mean the course to be run.
We're talking about Taylor's four fundamental questions. The first one, what educational purposes or goals should the school seek to attain?
And also, we informed you about the second one, what educational experiences can be provided that are likely attain this purpose. Next one, how can these educational experiences be effectively organized? The last one of Taylor's question, how can it be determined whether this purpose or grades are attained by the student? One of the most important points we discuss, relation between curriculum design, Taylor fundamental question, and Walker naturalistic model. In this one we discussed, as shown in this diagram, evaluation of the program graduate, which include learning experience, give and take from evaluation. Both of them go to through coursework content and then go to program objective and then leading to program goals, which can be achieved by program and institutional philosophy. This is the first one related to how to develop curriculum. What is the structure of curriculum, which is integrated with the four questions of Taylor, which we just mentioned, and this question was also integrated by Taylor fundamental principle, which is called also platform of belief and vision. It is divided into decision, design decision, and deliberation. These two steps for Walker platform.
Also, including in Taylor question one, once again, Taylor's question 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't forget. Question number 1 concerning program philosophy. Question number 2 concerning educational experiences. While question number 3 organizing, continuity, sequence, and integration. The final question number 4 talking about evaluation. When we talk about the program philosophy, which is Taylor's question 1, before we talking, the questions, all the questions and answered, the four questions must be interrelated, each one building on the preceding question and answer. You can't answer the Taylor question 3 and 4 preceding Taylor's question 2 or 1. We have this sequence 1, 2, 3, 4. Question number 1, program philosophy and goals. Normative model of physical therapy professional education have been a gift to physical therapy educator. It represent micro environment or micro level and macro environment or level monograph. The apt monograph of macro environment, which demonstrate how philosophy and the goals of any physical therapy curriculum are embedded in a global environment that include what? The global environment. We're talking now about global environment, which is macro environment, society, health environment, higher education system, and the knowledge related to physical therapy. While micro environment and macro environment both together, if any one of them have any change of their component, it has to be considered changing in the physical therapy curriculum. Faculty time spent considering macro level and micro level philosophy and the goals is time well spent. What is the main function of normative model by APTA? Help educators define the body knowledge related to physical therapy. Number 2, provide a mechanism for existing, developing future professional education program to evaluate the refined curricula and also can be integrated professional vision for professional education into their vision. It can be defined the expected entry level performance of physical therapy. Monograph also can be used by educator to review how their course work in foundational and clinical sciences related to the content, terminal behavioral and instructional objective. Normative model and guide to physical therapy practice, both together are extremely useful source for any physical therapist, clinician, academic educator who carries the responsibilities to transmit the core knowledge of physical therapy to next generation.
However, it believes the program will influence the student growth. This assumption were developed by the faculty and provide the framework of the development and the direction for each individual to achieve all these through course work.
لو ركزنا شوية على التيلور question 2 هنلاقيه بيتكلم عن educational experiences while question 1 to remember concerning program philosophy. Educational experiences, which is Taylor question 2, once goal and philosophy are understood, the next question to be answered is what educational experiences are needed to achieve these purposes. Coursework in physical therapy programs usually consist of foundation sciences such as anatomy, pathology, therapeutic exercise, and management of patient with specific clinical problems such as orthopedic or cardiopulmonary, transcranial current content such as ethics, administration and research, and clinical education. Of course, the actual coursework is designed and offered depends on the program's practice expectation and type and depth of prerequisites coursework.
So from all this foundation, we can find that all of this foundation, whatever its level, will enable them to assume the multifaceted lifelong roles of healthcare professional, clinical practitioner, manager, teacher, learner, consultant, researcher, and advocate. Now we are move forward towards the third question, Taylor question regarding to organization. Organization continuity, sequences, and integration. Taylor suggests three factors to consider in organizing experiences of the curriculum. Here we are going to discuss Taylor question, which is related to how to develop curriculum. So the third one, organization composed of continuity, sequence, and integration.
Continuity referred to vertical reiteration of curricular element that is provided continuing opportunities for the student to practice and to develop the cognitive, affective, or psychomotor skills they have learned. For example, teaching a student good body mechanics in early basic skills lab must follow practicing and reiteration in clinical lab course.
This regarding to continuity, what about the sequences? Sequence is related to continuity, but move beyond the reiteration and development of single skills. Thus, it means process of having each experience build on the prior one experience, while moving increasing broader and deeper into more material. So spending same time with the patient every session could lead to poor sequences.
يبقى لما قلنا عن اتكلمنا عن الكونتينيوتي قلنا ان هي ريفير تو فيرتيكال ريتريشن، بينما النهارده او دلوقتي الانتجريشن عباره عن هوريزونتال ريليشن شيب اوف ليرنينج اكسبيرينسز. فور اكزامبل كينيسيولوجي اند اناتومي كورس ماي بي بليس توجذر سو same body segments are covered within similar time period. يعني الاثنين هتاخدوا في وقت واحد. And the knowledge gained in one course could overlap and clarify knowledge gained in the other course. There is a structural constraint to organizing a curriculum. إيه هي المعوقات اللي ممكن تكون موجودة وأنا بعمل organization for a curriculum؟ نمرة واحد, primary consideration is academic calendar of the university in which program is located. لازم أحط في اعتباري الأكاديميك كاليندر, هل هو هيسمح بتاع اليونيفرسيتي دوت ولا لا, ان انا اقدر احط او امشي او اشغل البروجرام دوت. الافيليبيليتي اوف كلينيكال سايتس, هل الاماكن هتسمح, هل في متسع من الاماكن ولا لا.
In addition to this constraint may facing the curriculum development, also clinics may have the greater number of the staff on vacation and also may facing faculty and clinical expertise must judge across class in different year of the program in different area. So here we justify or clarify this constraint to be considered when developing any program.
To summarize what we are talking about, question 3, which is organizing continuity sequences and integration. Once again, the organization of educational experiences should relate directly to fulfilling the program's philosophy and the expected outcomes of its graduates.
As we consider in this question continuity as vertical and integration as horizontal and the sequence in between, so we must consider concentration of how each student will perform after graduation rather than how technical skill has before first clinical setting. Now we are reach the last phase of Taylor question, evaluation. After we talk about program philosophy, educational experience and organization, now to reach the last step, evaluation. If the objectives, content, and the learning experiences, course, or clinical experience relate to the program philosophy or not, so it must be clear all of this must be related to the curriculum so we can evaluate.
Also, the student as well as instructor evaluation of each course and component will give the faculty a good sense of whether the programs are being attained or not.
Also, the ultimate measure is how the graduate in clinical practice. Program evaluation should cover all general and specific goals.
Some questions تطرح نفسها. Do the graduate, for example, know how to manage ambiguous and gap in knowledge? Are they able to communicate with people from different cultures and backgrounds?
Also, do they have love of learning, what is already learning? Can they teach patients, family, and colleagues in publicly? Do they demonstrate professional ethically behaviors?
Regular evaluation of recent graduates by survey, interviews, group will assist the program faculty in completing the curriculum design, connections, and answering the most important curricular questions.
So we reach the final evaluation. Did the educational program achieve what is stated it would achieve in the program philosophy and goals? Three types of curriculum by Isner is identified: implicit, explicit, non-curricular. First one, implicit curriculum includes the value, beliefs, and expectations that are transmitted to the student
by knowledge, language, and everyday actions of the academic and the clinical faculty. The three components of curriculum have been identified.
Explicit curriculum includes the prerequisite courses, the program stated philosophy and the goals outcomes, course objectives and required reading, the sequence and type of clinical affiliation and the faculty credential.
All these aspects of the curriculum can focus in university catalogs, program brochures and course syllabus.
Regarding to non-curriculum, includes the element that
are left out of the explicit curriculum.
Walker curricular platform. What is the Walker curricular platform? If we think about the first diagram we show, to develop or to design the program must consider three elements. Curriculum development is the first one, from the course to into evaluation, and second integrated element was tailor question, and now we talk about the third column from this figure is the Walker curriculum platform. So three must be integrated together to gain or to achieve or to outcomes suggest success curriculum.
That means there was a relationship between curriculum design, Taylor's fundamental questions, and Walker naturalistic models, which we'll talk about now. Walker curricular platform is proposed by Dicker Walker. It is a naturalistic model of how faculty really go about developing a curriculum.
We found the Walker state what? The word platform is meant to suggest both political platform and something is stand on. This platform includes an idea of what is and vision of what ought to be. So Dicker talk about the platform include idea and what is the vision of it would ought to be above it. This guides the curriculum developer in determining what should to do to realize his vision.
If we remember again the table which فاتت اتكلمت عنه من شوية, هنبص نلاقي ان في تسلسل تيلر عمله, ان هو is an orderly progression from goal objective to the objective to the content and then to the evaluation as suggested by Taylor. طب هل ووكر او ديكر ووكر هل ماشي بنفس النظام؟ قال لك لا. Instead faculty move back and forth between all of these elements in process of deliberation. This deliberation inform a decision design acquisition. Okay, we believe that Taylor and Walker model are useful in helping faculty understand the process of curriculum development. Taylor delineated the component part of the process, and Walker described how faculty actually discuss, debate, and negotiate to arrive at a curriculum. It is useful for all academic and clinical faculty members to have agreed on program philosophy and goals of them when preparing their academic or clinical course objectives and related learning experiences. During this preparation time, faculty can use the philosophy and the goals as a guide in their planning. For example, if the program included macro-level goals articulated by Rogers, the instructor would think about how to set up learning experiences that teach students to reason and manage ambiguous and gap in knowledge, or expand the students' capacity for constructive empathy. The program philosophy and goals and outcomes that provide platform on which the physical therapy program rests should be discussed and revised if necessary every year before curriculum planning for the following years.
Professional accreditation for physical therapy. Professional accreditation for the physical therapist is our aim. It is our dreams. We are, all of us, we are looking to achieve accreditation. The primary function of accreditation is to set and ensure performance standard within disciplines across colleagues and universities. These academic programs are judged by performance standard, which include quantitative criteria and qualitative analysis.
Quantitative criteria might include, for example, state board license, examination, scores of program graduate, and the professional qualification of the faculty. While qualitative analysis might include the type of learning experiences students are engaged in and how these experiences impact the performance of the program graduates. يعني معنى كده ان في فرق بين quantitative criteria and qualitative analysis. We have we must know what is the difference between them. Qualitative analysis might include the type of learning experiences students are engaged and how impact on the performance of the program of graduates.
This judgment can only be made by the other people, and thus on an site peers reviewer visit is a common practice. In this way, the public is assured that the institution meets the general standard set for similar program and institution.
Thank you for listening.
Thank you, and wishing and looking for your question and to response for our assignment. Thanks a lot.